My name's Nick Stansfield, we're at the Black Sheep store. This is how to grip a skateboard deck. So firstly, what I've done, I found myself a nice area, got a nice surface to grip on. But what you want to do is, if you've got a bit of spare carpet, that would work perfectly. Luckily for us, we're in a skate shop. So Dickies have supplied us with a nice mat. What this will do is, this will prevent the skateboard deck, the graphic, from getting scratched if there's any, like, you know, debris on your surface. So now I've got that, you've got your skateboard deck, you've got your grip tape, you've got your file, your Stanley, that's all you need. So firstly, what you want to do is, generally most decks come with cellophane on. First step, to take the cellophane off. Pretty straightforward. Discard of that, you don't need that. So now you've got your board, it's quite happy. Have it placed like that in front of you, lengthways. Second stage is to take the grip tape and then peel off the backing. As so. You want to keep the paper backing because you'll need that in the near future. So then, this is the tricky part. Grab your grip tape lengthways. You've got your index finger and your thumb. You want to hover it but not touch the deck. So make sure the whole board's covered because obviously you don't want any of the deck to not be gripped. So I'm quite happy with that lengthways. Then you want to make sure it's covered widthways. And then you can place it down like that. So next stage is to start in the middle, push down, work your way up. Doing one side at a time. Next side. Then what you want to do, grab the paper backing that you've saved, simply place that over it, and then push any air bubbles out. Making sure there's no air between the grip and the deck. So I'm pretty happy with that. Discard. So the next stage is, grab the Stanley blade, cut four slits where you'd imagine the wheels would go. You want to make sure you don't go into the board, so you feel for the edge of the board, push down a little, right, I'm happy that'll go there. So the reason why we do this is because when you're filing the board down, it won't crease up or pop up in any areas. It will also come make it a lot easier when cutting the excess grip off. So now it's time to file the board down. So I generally start this point here. So just lightly filing. As you can see, starting to see the outline of the deck. Now it's starting to come together. What we need to do now is cut off the excess grip. So you've got yourself a Stanley. I've used a fresh blade because it's easier, it's sharper. So then you want to start, the reason why we've done the four slits as well is because obviously you can now do this part in stages. You've got four stages to do, it'll just make it a lot easier for yourself. So we start with the long edge, this is what I prefer to do. Follow the line that you've made when you were filing it down. This part's a bit trickier, but just follow this simple step. Don't angle the blade into the board, but follow the board. You can stop at any time, carry on. Once you've gripped your deck, you may find there's a few air bubbles lurking in the grip. Simply what you want to do is just grab the Stanley blade, pierce the bubble and push the air out. It's pretty simple. Sometimes you'll have loads, sometimes you'll have none. That's it. There's your board. Complete. Go shred.